check out these stubborn folks known as nail households around the world. They're the ones who give governments and developers a headache. Imagine this, a homeowner refuses to take a fat paycheck for their house and would rather fight tooth and nail to keep it. Some of these nail households are known for their sheer determination, while others stand for their principles. Their stories show us the toughest side of human nature. In China's Zhejiang province, an elderly couple's home was surrounded by a new highway. They refused to move due to compensation issues, becoming a prime example of a nail household. Meanwhile, in Wuhan, there's a ramshackle two-story shack right smack in the middle of a road in front of a hospital. It's run by the most persistent nail household around. And in Washington, D.C., a guy named Austin turned down a developer's offer of nearly $1 million to buy his house. He stood firm and opened up a pizza shop on his property instead. The developer had to construct their building around his little house, and it looks pretty silly now. These nail household stories might make you say wow. Their stubbornness could be seen as true courage and faith, or even a show of freedom and dignity. They fought for their rights and brought us some incredible tales. Let's take a peek at these top-notch nail households, and maybe they'll inspire us to pursue our own real thoughts and beliefs. The most stubborn and unfortunate nail house in Guangzhou was once a hot topic in the area. The house is located within the construction area of a road, and the owner's refusal to move caused the road to detour. The owner's refusal to relocate has attracted great attention from the local government and residents. To demolish the nail house, the local government has repeatedly offered the owner high compensation, including a demolition fee of 4 million yuan, but the owner remains unmoved. He believes that this place was passed down by his ancestors, and he will not give it up easily. The detour of the road not only affected traffic, but also the quality of life of local residents. The owner's refusal made many people very angry and disappointed. However, the owner was eventually forced into a helpless situation. Due to the construction of bridges on both sides of the road, his house is now sandwiched between two bridges, and the owner regrets it too late. His house has become a place of ridicule and disdain. This story tells us that while stubbornness and persistence can bring short-term glory, they may ultimately lead to irreparable consequences. In modern society, people should pay more attention to the public interest, comply with relevant regulations and laws, and not affect others' normal lives for personal gain. This is the craziest nail house in Japan. Due to the residents' refusal to relocate, the construction of the first runway of Tokyo Narita International Airport was delayed for more than a decade before it was completed. The second runway could not be extended to the required length, leading to repeated incidents of dangerous landings. The third runway is still on the drawing board and cannot be started yet. Narita Airport cannot provide night takeoff and landing services because, according to an agreement with several residents on the airport grounds, night operations are prohibited to avoid disturbing the rest of these nail house residents. This is the most principled nail house owner in the United States. According to the Washington Post, a man named Austin bought a two-story house in Washington in the 1980s. In 2007, a local developer offered to buy his property for nearly $1 million to develop commercial real estate on the land where his house stood. Austin refused to sell, as this price was 10 times higher than what he paid for it years ago. Austin instead wanted to open a pizza shop on his property. In the end, the developer compromised and built their larger building around Austin's small house, which looked quite comical. This is a nail household in Zhejiang, China. The demolition plan of this house began 4 years ago, but the owner has refused to move, blocking the progress of demolition. During this time, the government has offered many preferential policies, including high compensation and superior housing conditions, but the owner still refuses to agree. In an interview, the nail household said, "I have lived here for more than 30 years. I have many memories and emotions in this house. If I leave here, it will be like losing a part of myself." Although the owner's behavior may affect the progress of demolition and the interests of surrounding residents, his persistence also reminds people of a question: how to balance the interests among the government, residents, and developers when it comes to demolition. This story tells us that every social problem has different solutions, but all interests must be balanced. We hope that the government, residents, and developers can reach a compromise and find a solution that benefits everyone, promoting harmonious social development. This is the most fearless nail household in China. In the center of a building site that was dug 10 meters deep, stands a two-story house like a solitary boat in the middle of the sea. Chongqing netizens have dubbed it the most badass nail household in history. Since the developer posted the relocation notice on August 31, 2004, all 280 households in the area have moved out, except for the family of Wu Ping. After a 2.5-year standoff with the developer, Wu Ping and Yang Wu, the owners of the house, ultimately chose to compromise. Wu Ping and her family's house has become a symbol of resistance against forced demolitions and evictions in China, where rapid urbanization has led to conflicts between developers and residents. Despite facing immense pressure to leave, Wu Ping stood her ground and fought for her rights as a property owner. Her story has inspired many others to stand up against injustice and defend their homes and communities. Today, the house still stands in the midst of the construction site, a reminder of the struggles of ordinary people against powerful interests. The nail household phenomenon continues to be a contentious issue in China, but the resilience and determination of people like Wu Ping give hope to those who are fighting for their homes and livelihoods. In the bustling center of Guangzhou, there's a peculiar sight, a small house surrounded by four flyovers, becoming a unique landmark of the city. The owner of this house, Yang Jinming, is known as the happiest nail householder in China, and his story is not only moving but also inspiring. Yang Jinming, who is 70 years old now, has been living with his family in this small house for over 40 years. The house was initially built in this location due to a government demolition plan, but for some reasons, the government eventually did not demolish his house, making him a one-of-a-kind existence in the city. In this cramped space, Yang Jinming and his family have spent countless days and nights working and living here, and also finding happiness in this place. Although the house is surrounded by flyovers and bustling traffic, it has a sense of tranquility and warmth. Nowadays, this small house has become a famous landmark in Guangzhou. Large numbers of tourists come here every day to see this unique sight in the city. Yang Jinming has also become a unique figure, admired and moved by many for his perseverance and faith. This story tells us that no matter the environment, as long as we have faith and perseverance, we can walk further and wider on the path of life. Happiness may be around us, no matter where we live. Here, I would like to express our deepest gratitude to our nail households. It is their unwavering faith and persistent efforts that have protected our city and upheld its dignity and respect. We should cherish these nail households, for their efforts are not just for themselves, but for all of us. Let us stand together with them and contribute to the future of this city, making it even more beautiful and prosperous. Let us muster our courage, work tirelessly, and create more opportunities and room for growth in our hometown. Together, let us build this city into a better, more hopeful place, leaving a brighter future for our children and grandchildren. Thank you, everyone.